Coming back to the word of God, I was reading the scriptures. The Bible clearly says, the first scriptures, Matthew chapter 4, verse 23. Before we get into this message, the gospel of the kingdom of God, the blessings of the kingdom for the present and the future. For the present and the future. Remember, the gospel of the kingdom of God gives you the blessings of God in the present life and also in the future life. What is the present life? Present life, leading our lives on the earth. What is the future life? Or what is the future time you are going to receive the blessing when you go to the kingdom of God? Or when your soul goes into the kingdom of God? I was speaking to one of the sisters who had lost her mother. I remember I'd been to Cancer Institute and I started praying there. And as I was praying, I felt somebody standing all around. Cancer Institute. It was the last moment of that sister. And her children, her daughter was also present. And I told her, whatsoever it may be, I said, servant of God, I want to give you hope. I want to give you strength. I know you are in a very distressed manner or very big pain which you cannot control. She said, never mind. I think my hour has come to go. Only I'm asking the Lord that don't give me so much of pain, but take me. These were the words. And the children were there and everybody were there. And we started praying. I felt the moment. I told our daughter, come on, close your eyes and see who is there and what is going to happen. She saw the presence of the angels. And she saw that where we are standing, one was to the left or something. I don't remember the exact positions now. And the angel came forward. And when the angel came forward, she clearly able to see, because her brothers were also standing there and some other people were standing there. And I was standing the other side praying for her with the gospel. And during that time, a big crowd, but two angels came forward. And the angel was having a very broad shoulder, a very big height, which was going out of the roof of that room. And another angel was there steady, looking unto him to take the order and to do whatever things God is asking him to do for this lady. And then she saw that they discussed and they went away. Then I explained to her, this might be the hour as she spoke, that I don't want much pain and I want to go away from here. And probably this is my time, or my time has come that I should go to the Lord. And when, after saying that, when I was discussing with her daughter outside, she said that she saw the angel. I explained to her about the book of the Bible, Luke chapter 16. The angels of the Lord come and take the souls of Lazarus, the poor beggar. This is the sign, I said, so you can prepare. She said, I understood. Because for me, it was more clear than what you are telling me. I said, why? Because the angel talked to the other angel and they went away. So probably the angels are gone and giving the report to the Lord and coming back to take her soul. And same thing happened. Next day, she was not there. Next day morning, according to the time, the daughter goes and gives her something to eat. And she was reading the gospel. And she closed her eyes, saying the same thing. That the angels are come to take my soul. One thing is very important during those times that I visited so many times to the sister who was in our congregation. One time we all were praying together, and it was an understanding from the scriptures about the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Who is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords? Our Lord Jesus, right? Our Lord Jesus is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who was born as a king but was in manger. Who was king but had nothing to have himself. There was no place for him. Who was a king or born as a king but no silver, no gold, nothing at all. His earthly parents also has to suffer. But the Bible clearly says he was born as a king. And there was surprise. The kingdom was shaken up. Who is this king who is born? Let us finish all the children, those who are male, and finish them so that this king also shall be finished. My brothers, my sister, But when the second coming of our Lord Jesus is there, the Bible says he is not going to come as a king. When he came as a king on the earth, who judged him? Who judged him? This is now. Now, this revelation now. This understanding now, I got it when they were singing that song. In the earth, who judged him? Kings of the earth. Correct? He was taken to Pilate. Then he was taken to Caiaphas. He was taken to Herod. All the kings were judging him. Who were they? They were earthly kings. When he was born as a king on the earth, earthly kings were judging him and making the decision about him, that what is to be done. Then they had a message from the priest, high priest, and Sadducees and Pharisees, that he is casting out demons by the Beelzebub. He is also saying that he is the Son of God, which is against our scripture or against the faith or Christianity or against our Christian faith. And he forgives the sins of others. These are the accusations for him. But what happened? The kings could not find fault in him. Being a king, they could not judge him. But the other normal people judged him. During that time, Barabbas was brought. Jesus was standing there. And all the people were questioning. And then Caiaphas said that there one has to die. One has to die. One has to die to pay the penalty of the sins of the others. So whom do you want? You want Barabbas or you want Jesus Christ? And they said, we want Barabbas. They said, we want Barabbas. And then the question was another, what shall we do with Jesus Christ, your king? The king of the Jews. They were knowing the king. They were king. They also knew that Jesus Christ of Nazareth is king. They confessed, what shall we do with your king, king of the Jews? Come on, put the board on the cross of Calvary so that the king of Jews is no more and finished on the death. But my brothers, my sister, the second coming, he is not going to come as a king. He is going to come as a judge. He is not going to come as a king. He was already judged by the kings of the earthly. But the second time, he is not going to be coming as a king so that again the earthly kings to judge him. No, he is going to come as a judge so that he shall judge all the kings, those who are on the earth, those who did not make the proper decision, those who crucified him, those who suffered to die on the cross of Calvary. Sadducees and Pharisees did not realize. People, those who had the gospel, they did not realize. They said, we are also preachers, but this man is preaching all about casting out demons. Who is he who is calling the Son of God and who is forgiving the sins of others? They did not have the knowledge of the Word of God being with Jesus Christ our Lord. They never wanted to hear. The Bible clearly says that is the reason when Jesus was on the earth, he was preaching about the kingdom of God. Kings were foolish. Sadducees and Pharisees did not understand his plans. Priests and high priests did not know that he's come to pay the penalty of our sins and sins of the others and sins of the world. They did not understand. He is talking the word of God and he is the word of God. They did not understand. And every time Jesus was concerned about the kingdom of God of kings, kingdom of God of the people, kingdom of God of the church, kingdom of God of Sadducees and Pharisees, and kingdom of God of all the people. Therefore, Jesus said, my kingdom is not of this earth. Understand the scriptures. We had the messages. The messages were talking to us and telling us. The first message that we had about the gospel of the kingdom of God, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom. Number two, then we saw the nature, the gospel of the nature of the kingdom of God. Then the third thing that we saw, establishment through the gospel of the kingdom of God. And now tonight we are going to see the blessings of the kingdom of God through the gospel. Remember, you and I cannot be blessed unless and until you have a gospel in your life. Unless and until you read the word of God. Unless and until you believe the book of the Holy Bible. Unless and until you read the word and understand the word of God. You will not be shaken up. You will not be shaken up.
Today in Psalm 27, the Bible says, even though trial, tribulation, calamity is problem, but in those days, yet I will be calm. I will rejoice. I think verse 12, 13, 14, Psalms 27. Deliver me not over unto the will of mine enemies, for false witnesses are risen up against me, and such as breathe out cruelty. I had fainted unless I had believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. Get back to Psalm 27, verse 1. The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked, even mine enemies and my foes, came upon me to eat my flesh, they stumbled and fell. Though an host should encamp against me, my heart shall not fear. Though war should rise up against me, in this will I be confident. One thing I have desired of the Lord, that will I seek after, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to behold the beauty of the Lord and to inquire in his temple. For in such time, this is the one, in the time of trouble, he shall hide me in his pavilion, and in the secret of his tabernacle shall he hide me. He shall set me up upon a rock. Verse 6, and now shall mine enemy's head, now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing. Yeah, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Verse 7, hear, O Lord, when I cry. With my voice have mercy also upon me and answer me. Verse 6, please. Verse 6, and now shall mine head be lifted up above mine enemies round about me. Therefore will I offer in his tabernacle sacrifices of joy. I will sing, yeah, I will sing praises unto the Lord. Trials, tribulation, suffering, attack of the enemy. But still, I will be singing joyful songs and praising God. Now, the word of the Lord clearly says, when you do that, you have a confidence in God. You know that God is controlled in every situation. You will not put your countenance down. You will not be crying inside. You will not be weeping and troubled. You know that God is controlled in control of your situation. This is very, very important. The Bible clearly says that God has a plan. Matthew chapter 4, verse 23. The Bible says, Matthew chapter 4, verse 23, and Jesus went about all Galilee, teaching in their synagogue and preaching the gospel of the kingdom. Remember the title, preaching the gospel of the kingdom and healing all manner of sickness. And all manner of disease among the people. That's what the Bible says about. The same thing is said in Matthew chapter 9 verse 35. Matthew chapter 24 verse 14. And in all this gospel, it is talked about the kingdom of God. Or the preaching of the gospel of the kingdom. And this is given unto us to understand. That the gospel is given to understand for the kingdom of God. When you have the book of the Bible in your hands. When you read the word of the Lord, when you read the gospel of Jesus Christ our Lord, your aim must go with all manner of healing, deliverance, blessings, and victory, and success. After all, going all around here, it shall reach unto the kingdom. Your soul must always thirst for the kingdom of God. Sometimes I sin, sometimes we break the law, sometimes we break the commandment of God, sometimes we don't have a perfect relationship with God, but yet our connection should be go all doing all these things to the kingdom of God. Whether I am connected to the kingdom or not, whether I am connected to the gospel of the kingdom of God or not, this is very, very important. Another word is the words in a simple manner that I have brought unto you, that whether you have the blessings of the kingdom of God or not. You should be able to understand after doing all that. God is healing you. God is delivering you. God is blessing you. God is giving you finances. Promotions are coming. Businesses are starting. Sons are born. Daughters are born. I asked the lady after 14 years, 12 years, when she was pregnant and she got a baby boy now. I asked her, what is the name that you're going to give? She told me over the phone the name of the hero. I said, what? Yeah, this is a very famous hero. You don't know him? I said, no, I know. I know one hero, famous than that. I think you don't know, I said. No, it is not possible. We are watching film very regularly. Really? What is the name? She gave me the same name. Then after that I said, I have a very famous hero more than him. You don't know. It cannot be, she said. Yes, I will tell you the name. And I gave the name of J-E-S-U-S. I said, I'm just saying it. You write it down or you try to recollect it. What is this? I said, Jesus. Correct? Only 5-letter word. I said, you need not to give him the name Jesus, but you can understand these blessings of God through whom you have received, because he's a miracle working God. You got a miracle. What exactly is happening in our life? We are missing the target. God gives us every blessing. 12 years you did not receive. Now you have received, but yet your connection is not with the God. Yet you don't want to connect your sons and daughters to God. Miracle you are holding in your hands, but you are not connected to the kingdom of God. What exactly is happening? You got the miracle, you got the finances, you got the healing, you got the deliverance, dying man comes back to life, everything is okay. And after all this has happened, you are still not getting connected to the kingdom of God. So the biggest blessings you are losing. Therefore God is saying to you that you must be able to concentrate on the gospel of the kingdom of God so that you shall not lose the blessings that is waiting for you. Here it is beginning, there it is continuing. It is not ending there. Here it is given, there it is continued. Many people say, here it is going to begin and there it is going to end. No, kingdom of God does not end. There is no end for the kingdom of God. And you shall not think like that. You shall always think, it is going to begin or it is going to start here and I am going to continue there in the kingdom of God. The Bible clearly says, therefore, one has to understand about the kingdom of God's blessing. Number one, the present blessings. What is the blessings of the kingdom of God in the present life? Colossians chapter 1. Tonight we are going to pray at the end in a very special way. And not only that, next Wednesday I'm going to send you the clip about next Wednesday. Next Wednesday is going to be a special fasting and prayer, a special subject. That day we are going to take only songs and prayers. Songs and prayer. Songs and prayer. And we are not going to sit like that. We are all going to stand. Everyone will leave their chair to the right side and come out. And they will pray loudly. They will shake their hands. They will lift up their hands. They will cry out unto the Lord. Because you are going to jump into the new season. The old season baggage we are not going to carry. Amen. Old season baggages we are not going to carry. We will not suffer with those things again. We have to leave it. And without the prayer, you cannot leave that burden away. You have to have a new changes. Simply, we are going to celebrate New Year celebration. New blessings of God we talk about. And nothing is happening. This is not the will of God. So next Wednesday, remember, we are going to have a special fasting and prayer subject. And we are going to gather here. I'm going to send the clip later. Tomorrow you will get the, tonight and tomorrow you will get the clips of all the services of Christmas and New Year. Meantime, this also will come up. And you shall be able to understand. The word of God clearly says, what is the first blessings of the kingdom of God? Very important. Very important. All the time you have to remember in the Old Testament, God was concerned about Adam and Eve's sin. When Eve and Adam sinned, God was very much concerned. Every time he used to come to talk to them. They were totally naked. Look at this man. There was no prayer in the garden. Eve was not praying in the garden. Adam was not praying in the garden. There was no need for praying in the garden. Why? They're talking directly to God and God is answering them directly. Are you understanding? God is talking to Adam directly and God is talking to Eve directly. So there was no prayer required. They were so much blessed. But what was required? The reminding through their spiritual life was required. The first and the foremost commandment of God, you shall not touch the tree and the fruit thereof. So that the day that you shall touch and eat the fruit thereof, you shall surely die. Though God was talking to them, but they forgot about the command. Though God was all the time with them in the afternoon days, he was seeing Adam what he's doing. He was going and naming the animals. He was going and naming the plants. He was going and naming the trees. He was going to the seashore and he was telling the fishes and naming their names. And God was watching him. And God was watching Eve roaming around the garden. All this God was watching. There was no need for them to pray. But one thing was required. that they had to remember what God has told them. The grace of God that was upon them. The mercy of God that was upon them. The blessings of God that was upon them. The entire Eden garden that God had given unto them. They had forgotten. That's why prayer nowadays is so important, so that I and you shall not forget the blessings of God. Therefore, God has told you, remember Colossians chapter 1. What was important in that Eden garden? When they sinned, God came down again there in the Eden garden? Yes. God did ask to Eve and Adam, where are you? Yes. But after that, what did God do? God slain an animal, took the skin of the animal, and covered Eve and covered Adam. What did God do there? God forgave their sins by sacrifice of the animal's blood and again made them clean and covered them and sent them out. And kept the cherubims and seraphims to guard the garden so that they shall never enter. Not only that, even the devil should not enter there to tempt somebody else and destroy their lives. Bible clearly says, Colossians chapter 1 verse 13 and 14.
Who had delivered us from the power of darkness and had translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son.
Yes.
In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sins.
The Bible clearly says in verse 13, who had delivered us from the power of darkness that has started this procedure by God has started in Eden garden as soon as they were touched by the devil. The Lucifer who came and deceived Eve and Adam as they went into the darkness. That's why they were hiding themselves and they were not coming into the light. Because into the light their sin will be noticed. That's what they saw and they thought. But sin was noticed. Voice was heard. They knew, God knew what they have done. And therefore God was asking, Adam, where are you? They themselves went and hid themselves in the garden, behind the bush, going back to the darkness. And the Bible said this procedure of God started in Eden garden. And what was that procedure? Who had delivered us from the power of darkness and
had translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son.
And translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. Verse 14 says, very good. In whom we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of our sins. Remember, in the beginning when Adam and Eve sinned, forgiveness came through the shedding of the blood of the animal by God himself. And in the New Testament, God allowed his Son to die for your sins and my sins. Allowed the young man to die at the age of 33 to shed his blood so that your sins and my sins shall be washed. Forgiveness of sin shall come to you. The Bible clearly says this is the present blessings of God through the blessings of the kingdom of gospel. God has given this and you should be able to understand. I should be able to understand. Many times I do a foolish thing. We do foolish things. Not able to understand the grace of God. Not able to understand the mercy of God. Not able to understand the forgiveness of God that is given unto us in the present situation now. Now it is given. And therefore the Bible clearly says the blessings of the kingdom of God, God is given unto us in the present situation. Though we sin, we can go to God and say, Lord, I have done this, please forgive. Ready? God is not asking you to shed your blood. God is not asking you to bring the ram or lamb or any turtle doves. God is not telling you, bring, where is your sacrifice, sin sacrifice? No. God is only telling you one more time, look, your price is paid by Jesus. Your blood is already paid, your sins, the forgiveness of sins, price is paid by the blood of Jesus. Therefore, you are receiving that forgiveness. This is the first important thing. Revelation chapter 1, verse 4 and 5. In Revelation chapter 1, 4 and 5, the reason I'm taking this book and going back to the Revelation so that you shall know the completion of God for forgiveness. You shall be able to understand this is the present, that forgiveness of God. This is the present kingdom of God's blessing that is come unto us. Today also every one of us are forgiven by the grace of God. And this is the present actually blessings from the kingdom of God. Revelation chapter 1 verse 4 and 5.
John, to the seven churches which are in Asia, grace be unto you and peace from him which is and which was and which is to come, and from the seven spirits which are before his throne.
And from the seven spirits
which are before his throne.
Before his thrones. The next word is very important, verse 5.
And from Jesus Christ.
From Jesus Christ.
Who is the faithful witness.
Who is the faithful witness and the first begotten of the dead. Then.
And the prince of the kings of the earth.
Yes.
Unto him that loved us and washed us from our sins in his own blood.
He has washed us. He has cleansed us. He has sanctified us with his own blood. The Bible has a record in the beginning as well as at the end. The Bible tells you in the present status that you have been washed. You have been cleansed. You have been sanctified by the blood of Jesus Christ our Lord. This is the greatest of blessings. Because when you are washed, cleansed by the blood of Jesus, you are able to enter into the kingdom of God. So the gospel is making you to enter through the blood of Jesus, washed, cleansed, and by sanctified. This is your present situation. I unclean myself. I become dirty by sin. But there is a remedy for me to get washed by the blood of Jesus Christ on earth. And through the gospel of the blood of Jesus Christ, the blessings of the kingdom of God is restored in my life and your life also. This is what God is saying. This is your present blessing. Then this is called the forgiveness of sins which has come to you. In the Old Testament through the animal, in the New Testament through Jesus Christ our Lord. That's why I gave you the example in the beginning itself about the king. He has to pay the price. Therefore, earthly king, just him. Now, second time, he's not going to come as a king. If he comes as a king, then these kings are still there. Kings are still ruling. They can still judge him. No, he's not going to give them the chance to judge. Second time, he's going to judge because he's not going to come as a king. But he's going to come as a judge. And when he comes as a judge, everyone will get their reward correctly. There is no way that they shall miss. And that is called the future blessings of the kingdom of God. Coming back to the second thing, the Bible clearly says, it is the care of God upon your life. The gospel of the kingdom of God is a blessing for you in the present sense. What is the present? It is the God's care. That God cares for you. What is required for you? What is to be given for you? What is your need? First of all, in Eden Garden, when Adam was created, God's eyes were upon Adam. God was watching him, naming the animals, roaming around here and there. And then God saw also, the Bible clearly says, God saw him. He saw him alone. But he was alone. He was not alone. Why? There was somebody in his body already. Rib out of his rib, bone out of his bone, flesh out of his flesh was already there inside him. Because the day God created Adam, God created them as male and female. And Adam was roaming here and there and naming them, but female was already there. But yet the Bible clearly says, God saw him. He was alone. And therefore God created him a helpmeet. The blessings of the redemption, the blessings of the future, the blessings of the companion, the blessing that God wants to give it to you is in you. It is in you. God has already given that redemption. God has given you that forgiveness. God has made you to understand. The Holy Spirit of God in you is telling you, you have sinned. You have done righteous things. You have broken the law. You are not broken the law. You are remembering the word. You are not remembering the word. You are not respecting the word. All that Holy Spirit of God is working in your life to tell you. Making your present situation about the kingdom of God study. And the Bible clearly says, therefore God cares about everyone. Those who are unstudied. This is the worldly language. But God cares for everybody, those who are sinners. Those who did not receive their blessing. They go away from the blessings of God. God wants to bless every man and every woman. In fact, God called Adam and gave him a sleep to bless him. Similar way, God calls you and wants to bless you. And make you realize about the kingdom of God of the future and of the present. In the present kingdom of God, that is the earthly. Earthly blessing also you should receive. You should not be beggar. You should not lose the blessings of God. You should have all the blessings of God. That is the plan of God. Then the Bible clearly says in Matthew chapter 6. Matthew chapter 6 verse 25 to 34. Therefore what Jesus said, don't worry. Don't be angry. Don't be anxious. Don't think that, oh, things are over. Finished. Nothing will happen to me. I will not be prosperous. Oh, this problem will always be there. This trouble, why it's coming? This type of thoughts will never come to you when you are connected to the kingdom of God. And the Bible clearly says, when you understand the blessings of the kingdom of God, these worries will not come, because God has already connected you for the blessings of the kingdom of God. You will not say, why I did not receive this? Why I did not receive that? Why my promotions are not come? Why my blessings are not come? Why I'm still sick? Why I'm weak? Why am I anxious? Why depression? This will never happen to the child of God who is connected with the blessings of the kingdom of God. Now you check up yourself. Are you connected to the blessings of the kingdom of God, or are you connected to the worldly things of sorrows, pain, agony, sorrows, difficulties, sickness, problems, trials, tribulations? Smallest the things happen, but you feel like weeping. Smallest the things happen, and you say, everything is gone, brother. You don't know what happened to me. Coming back to the word of God, Matthew chapter 6, 25 to 34. Read it nicely. Come on, blow up the congregation.
Therefore I say unto you, take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink.
This is said by Jesus Christ our Lord, the man who did not have a house. The Bible says Jesus Christ of Nazareth became pauper to make you rich. He had no houses so that you shall have houses. He took all the sins upon his body so that you shall not be sinner, and the sinner cannot go to the kingdom of God. Therefore he made the provision for you so that you shall enter into the kingdom of God. The righteous man receives all the blessings of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all other things shall be added unto you. That's what God said. That's what the Bible says. Therefore Jesus was making the provision for you to get into that kingdom blessings of God. And he took everything so that you shall enjoy the life with the kingdom blessings of God. And the Bible says, verse 25. Therefore I say unto you, Jesus is saying, take no thoughts for tomorrow, for your life, what you shall eat or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body. My brothers, my sister, airport closed, people started thinking. We are only thinking, you and me, we are maybe thinking about passengers. But there are very wise people in this world. And I have some wise people in our congregation. Brother, airport closed. Yes, brother, passengers are not here. Forget about passenger. Who will bring the cargoes? Food items. You must go and take the cargoes. You must go and take this food. You must go and store the food. Don't ask me who said this. What happened to this man? He's also a believer. He's also coming to the church. What exactly is the thought in his mind? He has so much of thought about all these things, not having the thought that he is the provider. When I put my trust in him, all these things will be added unto me. Amen. Are you doing the same thing, or are you trusting in God? Are you knowing that you are connected to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, who has given you the kingdom blessings of God on the earth for the present, and who is also going to give you for the future? I don't think that I'll be able to complete for the future blessings, but surely the present blessings are very important to think about. Are you connected to the gospel of Jesus Christ our Lord, or gospel of the kingdom of God, so that you shall see the gospel, or you shall see the blessings of the kingdom of God in your life? Surely this man is not seeing. I said, this is my message tonight. What is the message? Kingdom blessings of God. When you are connected to kingdom, you can see the blessings of God. When you are not connected to the kingdom, you will be always seeing the earthly business. Always seeing the earthly things. You'll be afraid what is going to happen. When the airport will open. When the cargo will come. Will the cargo come inside? All the ports are also closed, brother. You don't know anything, pastor. Ports are also closed. Road also nothing. No roads, no border roads. Everything, every intermission he has. What has happened to this brother? What has happened to this family? Because the connection, they are trying to break it, looking unto the worldly problems. My brothers, my sister, therefore Jesus, whatever he says to you, it is so important for you to understand and take it inside. Take that word inside. Let that word be rooted in your hearts. Let that word come in your minds, so that you shall be able to speak for yourself, and you shall never be afraid about any situation that's working in. What is that the Bible says? Or what you shall drink, nor yet for your body, what you shall put on. Is not the life more than meat? Are we not thinking that we are alive? So nice it is. People have passed away. And people are actually gone so untimely. Families, when I talk to them, they immediately cry. They have no words. I ask them, what happened? They said, we cannot say how we missed. The children are saying, we cannot understand how we missed our daddy. At least we should have spoken to him at the last time. We were here and we were there and he was there and we could not.
The entire family was here when husband passed away in Goa, who went on vacation. My brothers, my sister, is not the life more than meat and the body than raiment? Life is more important than these clothes. What clothes I'm wearing, it is not nice. It is last year's school suit. I must take another one. All these thoughts are running in your mind. But actually, more than that is important that life has given unto us. After having this operation, God has kept me alive. Very important. These things makes you connected to the kingdom of God through the blessings of God that is released in the present life. And what is that blessing? God cares for you. First blessing, forgiveness of God for all your sins and my sins. Number two, God cares. All these things are your important things, but God cares something more than that, which is life unto you. You shall not have virus. You shall have no sickness. You shall not be troubled. You shall not meet with an accident. You shall have no trouble at all. Your sons and daughters are not with you, but he will send the angel and take care of them. I guarantee you, my brother, I guarantee you. I'm experiencing that power, that blessings of God. For you, it may be like that. Little any problem, you might be thinking like that. Oh, what a trouble. What a trouble. What happened? They did like that. He did like that. Oh, this has happened to my son. The teacher shouted. Oh, that much? That's all. Teacher shouted, not touched her, not beaten her, only shouted. But so much of commotion in our family, not realizing that yet under the control of teacher, our children are safe. Say amen. Where we are going to take care of our sons and daughters. But God is doing that. There are so many other ways to talk about. The next important thing the Bible speaks about. Go ahead. Verse 26.
Behold, the fowls of the air. For they sow not, neither do they reap, nor gather into barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Are ye not much better than they?
Remember, this scripture is given unto you and to me to understand the blessings of the present life. Even the birds of the air, fowls of the air, and the animals in the wilderness or in the forest that you see, God is providing them. God is providing. Otherwise, they cannot find their food. The Bible says, behold, the fowls of the air, for they sow not. They don't sow anything. Neither they reap, nor gather into the barns. Yet your heavenly Father feedeth them. Our heavenly Father is giving unto them. You are much more precious than the fowl of the air. You are much more precious than the wild animals in the forest. You are much more precious than the fowls of the air that fly here and there. Much more precious, because what exactly God has done for you. The fowls of the air are created by his word. Let there be birds, and birds were created. Let there be fishes, fishes were created. But to you and me, he came down from heaven. He gathered the dust of the ground with his own hands, with his own hands, with his own hands. He has prepared you and prepared me and given us the life and breath into our nostrils, the breath of life. We became living soul. Soul is living in us. So we are much more precious than that. The Bible says, are you not much better than them or they? And what is your answer tonight? Yes, we are better than them. 100 times better than them. They are created by the word of the Lord. We are created by his hands. They don't have the breath of God, but we have the breath of God. Our life is not taken care by anybody else, but he takes care of our lives. The kingdom blessings of God is on the earth for you, so that you shall experience the kingdom blessings of God, and you shall reach unto heaven, not losing that blessing that is much more than this. A biggest palace is there, mansion is there, biggest house is there, biggest accommodation is there, biggest type of things are there, where weeping is not there, sorrows are not there, tears are not there, pain is not there, agony is not there, brokenness is not there, broken homes are not there. Everything is joy, peace, happiness. Everything that you missed here is going to come there for you. So therefore, don't miss anything. Understand the blessings of God for the present situation that has come to you through the gospel of the kingdom of God, so that you shall recognize the present blessings of the kingdom of God in your life. Coming back to the word of God, the next verse.
Which of you, by taking thought, can add one cubit unto his...
Who can pleasure? Save your life by worrying? I also cannot save. I cannot get anything by worrying. Worry does not give you any blessing. Worry, I always say like this. Worry does not add blessings of God for you when you worry. Or does not remove any problems that you are suffering with and reduce you from the troubles. They remain there only. All is working here. Either it is going high or going down. Nothing is working on. Worry does not change your situation.
worry does not release or increase your faith. Worry does not bring the protection of God in your life. Therefore, Bible clearly says, God cares for you. Even if you are trying to care, your care is useless, but God cares for you. The next verse, 28.
And why take ye thought for raiment?
Yes.
Consider the lilies of the field,
how
they grow. They toil not, neither do they spin.
Even the lilies of the valley or the flowers of the field, that does not do anything, but they get everything. The next word, 29. And yet I say unto you, that even Solomon in all his glory was not arrayed like one of these. The next word.
Wherefore, if God so clothe the grass of the field, which today is and tomorrow is cast into the oven, shall he not much more clothe you, O ye little faith?
You must be able to understand that God is going to give me A to Z, everything that is needed in my life. Verse 31.
Therefore, take no thought, saying, what shall we eat? Or what shall we drink?
Yes.
Or withal shall we be clothed?
Verse 32. For after all these things do the Gentiles seek, for your heavenly Father knoweth that you have need of all these things. The Gentiles, those who do not know God, they always think about their intellectual mind. They think that I knew here, these things are available. I went there and I got it. They talk about their merit. They talk about their intellectual sense. They talk about their education. They think about their strength. But you should know, your blessings are not come like that. Your blessings are given by the Heavenly Father. If you are connected to the kingdom of God, you know all your blessings are coming from heaven, though you are gathering them on the earth. It's all given to you by Heavenly Father. The Bible clearly says 33 and 34. I will read for you. But seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added unto you. God is telling you, seek the very important. No matter whatever trial, tribulation, suffering, sorrows, pain, agony, brokenness, but seek the kingdom of God so that you shall be able to know that your blessings are restored. All these things God will surely give it to you. Seek first the kingdom of God. The 34th verse, the Bible clearly says, take therefore no thought for tomorrow, for the morrow shall take thought for the things of itself. Sufficient unto the day is the evil thereof. Whatever is the day of thoughts are there, that thoughts are also not good for you. Those blessings are also not good for you. When you are connected to God, they become good. Otherwise, all evil and evil and evil. Because devil is controlling this world. Therefore, Bible is clearly saying, God is controlling. I will just quickly say two important things, and then we shall close down. The Bible clearly says, God is controlling every man's life and giving them every manner of provision and blessings of God. God wants, according to Psalm 34, and so also Psalms 84, Bible clearly said, therefore, every man and every woman should know the Creator. Number two, every man and every woman should be able to submit themselves to the Creator. Number three, the Bible clearly says, they shall be able to know that their benefits are not because of their merit, but it is given unto them by the God Almighty. And when you receive these blessings, you are blessed on the earth with the blessings of the Lord God Almighty, who is seated in the heavenly places. So God sends the blessings of God from heaven to you, and you are blessed. So kingdom blessings of God is coming unto you in the present situation. And the Bible clearly says, so also it takes care of your family. So also it takes care of your individual life. So also it takes care of your loneliness. So also it takes care of your food. He also clothes you with your, you know, whatever the things are there, plus righteousness of God. He puts the garment of righteousness and he gives you. The final thing, the Bible clearly says, God gives you his spirit, which you shall not forget. The man who has the Spirit of God has the thought of God. The man who does not have the Spirit of God inside cannot think about God, cannot think like God, cannot act like God, cannot pray like God, cannot cast out demons like God, cannot do anything. Cannot do anything. Therefore, the man and woman must be able to understand. If you are seeking the present blessings of the kingdom of God, you must have the Spirit of God. Spirit of God will tell you righteousness. Spirit of God will take you to the holiness of God. Spirit of God will tell you not to worship idols. You are hearing 100 times, but the mind is not changing. Ways are not changing. Understanding is not coming to you. Why? You are not connected to the kingdom of God. You are afraid about society. You are afraid about people. But you are not afraid about God, who is able to destroy our soul as well as body. We are only afraid about the body, which will be destroyed by the society, by the people, by the relatives. Oh, what they will do. People are killing, no? Those who are actually Christians or those who are preaching the gospel, they are persecuting them. Even killing them. Burning them.
But the soul is saved. The soul is eternally saved. The reward in the heavenly places is great. All the martyrs will be sitting around Jesus Christ our Lord, the Bible says. But who can understand this? A British man cannot understand. They feel that their religion, right? They have to do like that. I am in this religion. I will continue in that religion because he is not connected to the kingdom of God and the Spirit of God is not in him. The Spirit of God who has will always connect himself through the word of God, through the knowledge of God, through the blessings of God to the kingdom of God.